Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Shivangi Upadhyay from Uttarakhand Open University. Today, I will discuss about direct product of group. First, we will discuss about external direct product. Let G1, G2, G3, Gn be finite collection of groups. The external direct product of G1, G2, G3, Gn written as G1 times G2 times G3 times and so on times Gn. It is the set of all n tuples for which the ith component is an element of Gi and the operation is component wise. We consider G1 comma G2 comma G3 and so on and last term Gn. This is the element of G1 times G2 times G3 times Gn, where G1 is element of capital G1, G2 is element of capital G2, G3 is element of capital G3, and Gn is element of capital Gn. That is, this n tuple G1, G2, G3, Gn is belong to G1 times G2 times G3 times Gn, such that small g1 belong to capital G1, similarly small g2 belong to capital G2, small g3 belong to capital G3, and small gn belong to capital Gn. Now, if we take two groups G and H, then the elements of G times H can be written as GH, where G belong to capital G and H belong to capital H. Let assume that star is a binary operation on G and delta is binary operation on H, and we have to define the binary operation on G time H. Then we consider two element G1 H1 and G2 H2 from G time H. When we apply operation on G cross H, then the element should component wise operate, that is G1 operate with G2 with operation star, which is the binary operation of G, and similarly H1 operate with H2 with the binary operation of H, that is delta. Thus G1 H1 binary operation G2 H2 can be written as G1 star G2 H1 delta H2, where delta is binary operation on H and star is binary operation on G, and here G1 and G2 belonging to G and H1 H2 belonging to H. The resulting set is a group, that is the direct product of finite number of group should be group. Now we will discuss about it. First, we have to prove that the direct product of finite group should be group. For that we will prove four axioms. First one is closure property. Which says that if A and B are the two elements of group G, then if we apply operation between A and B, let the operation define on GBB. And when we apply operation between A and B and we get the result C, then this C should be belong to this set of the set, or we can say the group. Similarly, now we will prove that the any binary operation between two elements is belonging to external direct product of group. Here we take G cross H and two elements from it, which is G1H1 and G2H2. When we apply binary operation between G1H1 and G2H2, we get G1 star G2 and H1 delta H2, where star is a binary operation defined on G and delta is binary operation defined on H. Here we can see that G1 star G2 is also belong to G, because G1 and G2 is the element of G which is a group, and group satisfies closure property. Hence, G1 star G2 belong to G. Similarly, H1 delta H2 belonging to H, because H is a group. Hence, we get that G1 star G2, comma H1 delta H2 belonging to G cross H. Now, we prove the property of associative. As we know that G and H is a groups and their elements should satisfy associative property. Hence, we can see that G cross H is also satisfy associative property. Next axiom is existence of identity. In this condition, we have to find an identity in the given set. Here, we will find the identity of the external direct product of a group. We take external direct product of G cross H. Here, we can easily see that G has an identity element E1, because G is a group. Similarly, H is a group and it has an identity element E2. Therefore, this tuple E1, E2 should belong to G cross H. Hence, E1, E2 is the identity of G cross H. Now, we will prove that for every element of G cross H, there exists an inverse element which is also belong to G cross H. Here, we take an element GH which is belong to G cross H. Now, we know that G belong to capital G and H belong to capital H. G and H both is group. Hence, capital G has an inverse of G and capital H has an inverse of H. Let G inverse is inverse of G on capital G, which is a group, and H inverse is the inverse of H, which is in H. Now, when we apply binary operation between the tuples GH and G inverse H inverse, we get G1 star G inverse H delta and H inverse, which is equal to E1 comma E2, because G1 and G inverse between the operation between the G1 and G inverse gives E1, because G1 and G inverse is the inverse element of G1. Similarly, H and H inverse operation between H and H inverse gives E2. Thus, for any element GH of G times H, there exists the pair G inverse H inverse such that GH G inverse H inverse is equal to tuples E1 E2, where G inverse is the inverse of G, which is belong to G, and H inverse is the inverse of H belong to H. Hence, for each GH has an inverse, G inverse and inverse, which is should be belong to G times H. From this, we find that G times H is a group. Similarly, we can say that G1 times G2 times so on Gn is also a group. Now, we will see an example of external direct product. We already know about R square, R3. R square is a two tuple set which is a group, and R3 is a three tuple set which is also a group. And in R square, it can be written as R square R, and R cube it can be written as R cube R times R times R. That is, these both are the example of external direct product. Now, we will find some elements between Euler group U5 and Euler group 12 after applying direct product between them. Here, we will find the element of external direct product between U5 and U12. First, I will explain what is Euler group. Let n is any integer. Let n is any positive integer. Let which is then Euler group on N is the set of all number which is prime to N. That is, Euler group is the set of all number which is coprime to N. Now, if we see an example, that is, if we have to find the element of group U5, then the elements are 1, 2, 3 and 4, as 1 is coprime with 5, 2 is coprime with 5, 3 is coprime with 5 and 4 is coprime with 5. Similarly, the elements of U12 are 1, 5, 7 and 11. We can easily see that 1 is coprime with 12, 5 is coprime with 12, 7 is coprime with 12 and 11 is coprime with 11. Here we have to clear this, that this all number should be smaller than 12. That is, we have to find all coprime which is smaller than that number n. Now, we will find the elements which formed when we apply direct product between U5 and U12. That is, U5 times U12 is equal to 1 1 1 1, then 1 5, then 1 7, then 1 11. Similarly, 2 1 2 5 2 7 2 11, then 3 1 3 5 3 7 3 11, 4 1 4 5 4 7 4 11. And hence we get the group of U5 cross U12. Now, if we apply operation between any two element of U5 cross U12, we will find that 2 7 3 11, as example, 2 7 and 3 11 are the two elements of U5 cross U12. Then when we apply operation between 2 3, that is 2 3 the 6 6 modulo 5, as the binary operation on U5 is mod 5. Similarly, the binary operation applied on U12 is mod 12. So 3 2 the 6 6 mod 5. Similarly, 7 into 11 77 modulo 12. Here we find that 6 modulo 5 is 1. That is, when we divide 5 with 6, we get the remainder 1. Similarly, when we divide 12 with 77, we get the remainder 5. Here we get the element 1 5, and we can easily see that 1 5 also belong to this group, which satisfy that U5 cross U12 is also satisfy the closer property. Now we will discuss about one important theorem which is based on external direct product. This theorem state that the order of an element in a direct product of a finite number of finite group is the LCM of the order of the component of the elements. That is, if we consider the finite number of group, example, if we take G1, G2, Gn are the finite number of group, then we form a external direct product, that is G1 cross G2 cross and so on times Gn. Then the element, one of the element of this external direct product is G1, G2, Gn. Then the order of this element should be equal to the LCM of order of G1, order of G2 and order of Gn. Now we will try to prove this theorem. For this, we consider only two group, which is G1 and G2, and here we take an element from this group, which is G1 and G2. Now we consider S, which is the LCM of G1, order of G1 and order of G2, and let T is the order of G1, G2, which is the element of G1 cross G2. Now, when we operate G1, G2, S times, then we find that G1 operate S times with G1 and G2 operate S times with itself. Then what we get? We get G1 times of S comma G2 times of S. As we know, S is the LCM of order G1 and G2. Hence, G1, which is operate S time, will give the identity element, which is E1. Similarly, if G2 operate S time, then we get E2, which is the identity element of G2. Thus, here we find that T should be divided as after operating G1, G2, S times we get the identity element of G cross H. Hence, the order of G1, G2 should divide S. Hence, it implies that T divide S. Thus, here we find that T should be smaller than equal to S. Here we will take this inequality as 1. Now, we already know that G1, G2 has order T. It means order of G1 T comma G2 T is equal to G1 is equal to G1 G2 operate T times, that is G1 G2 ki power T. It means this G1 G2 is equal to, which is operate T times, is equal to E1 E2, as G1 T is the order of G1 G2. If we apply G1 G2 T times, we get E1 E2, which is the identity element of G times H. Hence, here we find that the order of G1 should divide T and the order of G2 should divide T, which implies that T is a common multiple of G1 and G2. Hence, we get, if T is a common multiple of order of G1 and G2, we get that T is greater than equal to S, because S is the LCM, that is least common multiple. And if T is a common multiple, then T should be greater than S, that is S is smaller than equal to T, or we can say T is greater than equal to S. Here we see that T is smaller than S, and here we see S is smaller than equal to T. These two conditions implies that S should be equal to T. Thus, we get that S equal to T. Hence, we find that the order of G1, G2 is equal to LCM of order of G1 and G2. For general cases, suppose the above result hold for G1 cross G2 cross Gn minus 1. But as we know that G1 times G2 times Gn can be written as G1 times G2 times Gn minus 1 then times Gn. If this result, we already know that this result hold, and if we consider this a group and this is a group, then again from above proof we get that this whole should apply the result. Hence, we find by induction that the order of G1, G2, Gn, that means n tuples, is equal to LCM of order of G1, order of G2 and order of Gn. I hope you will understand basics, definition and theorems of external direct product. Thank you very much.